and it's Garnett in the pivot spot manning the middle. So it's Brooklyn now. And Williams, here we go. An easy layup after coming off the pick. Darren Williams enjoying an efficient season, shooting the ball last year, 2013-14. Steve, his best field goal percentage in years.
Yeah, and over the last two seasons, you know, his best consistent three-point shooting. So he's become a dependable threat from long range.
Here's Williams. The Warriors making the shot. Puts up the baby hook. And it's good.
Well done finishing that one off.
And now just over a minute played here in the first. Now here's Curry. He dishes it to Stevenson. Back to Curry. From downtown. Out to Smith. Smith right side. Dishes to Barnes. From the arc. They grab their own miss. From deep, Stevenson. Brooklyn with the rebound. Here's Williams. Garnett outside. Back to Williams. Four on the shot clock. Brooklyn needs to get off the shot here. Johnson can't get it to go. The Warriors have gotten only one of six shots to drop for them to start this game. Stevenson can't hit.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Here's Boozer. Banked in off the glass. Boozer's got his first 2 points.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
That's going to open things up for them on the perimeter going forward, Clark.
Curry attacking. High arcing shot. That's good.
Tell you what, he is so difficult to guard, especially on a shot like that one.
Boozer is screen on Curry. Layup off the pin. Williams can't hit.
Couldn't convert, but nice little two-man game there.
And it wouldn't surprise me to see them go back to that the next trip.
Stevenson again. It's Johnson. And that one's goodbye, Stevenson. And it's all knotted up.
The defense played him close on that one, but he just would not be denied. Aggressive move for the score.
Williams kicks to Boozer. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. That's on Chris Anderson.
Brooklyn Nets going all in last season. A record $89 million in luxury tax payments. On a mission to win a championship. Of course, it didn't happen, but the question is, where do they go from here?
So he comes up empty at the line.
And, you know, for the Nets, between their trades with the Hawks and the Celtics, they actually traded away most of their draft picks through 2018. So, you know, what you see is pretty much what you're going to get with this group.
Nobody near Barnes. Chance there to take the lead, missing. Williams again. It's Curry. It's Williams with the drive. That's good. Williams has got six. And you remember the Nets owner guaranteed a title within 5 years. That's this postseason. Said if he failed, he'd punish himself by, Steve, getting married.
Sure his future wife appreciates that comment.
Yeah, really.
I don't know. Maybe he's a romantic at heart, Kevin. Or maybe not.
What a way to get your marriage started.
Yes.
poor shooting from him this quarter. His shooting percentage nowhere near where he'd like it to be.
Johnson attacking. Let's it go with a three. Williams can't hit. The Warriors trailing. And here is Curry. Feeds it to Smith. The fadeaway. And the shot's good after hitting off the rim.
When he gets the fadeaway to go, I'd still rather see him go straight up with it.
Williams with the ball. 6 points for him. Pass to Johnson. He kicks it to Doug. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Well, last season, Jared Dudley was deemed to be a nice acquisition when he was traded to the Clippers. Back close to his hometown of San Diego, he's a veteran shooter, high IQ, was expected to flourish next to CP3, but didn't quite play out that way. He struggled all season.
And the Warriors making a change here. Lights checked in, and a change for the Nets. Ellis has checked in. And for Dudley, the downturn in his numbers was really across the board.
Yeah, sometimes, Kevin, it's difficult when you change teams and you play with new players in a different style. So Dudley did not have a good year. I think this season he's looking to bounce back, should be more comfortable in his environment, and he's looking for that bounce back season.
And a wide open look here for Ellis. Good. The nice assist for Williams.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
Nobody near Stevenson. Nailed from three-point land.
Oh, the rapid-fire threes coming from everywhere.
I thought it might be a little imprudent to try to get those points right back, but it worked.
Shots good by Boozer.
You know, of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is major smash-mouth basketball, guys.
Love it. Old school. Physical play in the paint. Dominate. Well, you can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
Curry against Williams. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
Darren Williams has really good size and strength at the point guard spot. And once he gets a step on the guy, it's hard to push him off his line.
Free throw good, Williams. And Williams with one of the better post-up games among point guards thanks to his strength.
Yeah, shows that veteran savvy. You know, he can hit you with the fadeaway or get you up in the air and work himself to the foul line. So, you know, this guy's a handful anywhere on the court.
Now here's Curry. 5 points in the game. To the inside. Trying to find Wright. He's got it now. And he gets it to go.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've seen him make over and over again.
Williams dishes to Boozer. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Josh Smith. Plumlee is checked in for Brooklyn. Golden State on D. Ellis with it. Guarded now by Barnes. Shot's good. Ellis has got five.
I tell you what, he's made more than a few of those in his career.
Curry kicks to Stevenson. Back to Curry. That ball. Nice feed that time from Stevenson. Curry's got the game tied up here for the Warriors. Nets have gotten 7 of their first 10 attempts to fall so far. Excellent pace to their offense. Plumlee sets the pick for Williams. And it's Ellis penetrating. And it's blocked by Wright.
Rebounding is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
Yeah, it's a physical game, and so far the numbers show that they've got the edge on the glass.
Beautiful play by Lance Stephenson. He's as gifted a passer as we have in the league.
Here's Williams, following the basket by Stephen Curry. Williams passes to Boozer. Turn around, Jay. Plumlee dishes to Boozer. Ellis outside. Boozer is three on Stephenson. Ellis takes it up with both hands and rips it down.
Boy, taking it hard to the rack for the big throwdown.
And give an unofficial assist, Clark, to his teammate for setting the screen that freed him up.
Yeah, good call. That was really the key to the play. Everybody on the floor is hot. Incredible stuff here in the early stages.
Tell you what, both teams playing downhill. Who's going to blink first?
Now here's Ellis. He's got seven. And stolen by Barnes. Curry attacking. Here's Stephenson. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. 7 points for Lance Stephenson. Outside Williams. From seven. Tried to bank it in, but he misses. Warriors leading by five. And Stephenson kicks to Curry. Back to Stephenson. Shot is off. Great defense that time from Ellis. The Nets have gone 8 of 14 from the field in the first quarter. Outside Williams. On the wing, Ellis. Five on the clock. Left side, Boozer. And again, no good by Brooklyn. The Warriors shooting it officially from the get-go. They're at 52% from the field. Some nice passing by Golden State here. Stephenson inside the three-point line. And another basket for Golden State.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they built this lead for themselves here.
And the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Brandon Wright, the former eighth overall pick back in 2007. For his career, Steve, a field goal percentage of around 60%.
Well, he's figured out his niche in the league. He wasn't sure what he was when he arrived, but he's a backup big. He's a diver. He's an offensive rebound guy. He's a lob catcher. So, you know, not a one-on-one scorer, but somebody who can play off of others very effectively.
Checked in for the Warriors. Then for the Nets, Kevin Garnett is checked in for Boozer. Johnson comes in for Jared Dudley. And it's Mills in for Williams.
And Wright, because he's lightweighted, can struggle in matchups with stronger opponents. But he is a shot blocker. His length really helps him in pick and roll situations.
Ellis kicks to Plumlee. Mills, that's a two-pointer. And again, no good by Brooklyn. Now Curry. He's got 12. Shot off the pick. The rebound by Johnson.
When he's wide open like that, he'll rarely miss those.
Here's Ellis. And so the... Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. And the Warriors, guys, what jumps out to you in this game, stats-wise?
Now, the key has been the rebounding department, this club dominating the paint area. And if this continues, they'll be in great shape.
Well, they've done two things. They've limited second chances, and they've been able to flex their muscle down low.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, as the second quarter gets going. And Golden State looking at who they've got. Brandon Wright is out there with Smith. Then it's Curry. Then it's Lance Stevenson. And it's Webster in at the three, the small forward. Warriors leading by seven. Smith, that's the pick for Stevenson. Smith, the pass to Webster. Kevin Garnett with the steal. Inside. Here's Mills. That's in, coming off an assist from Johnson. Mills got the second quarter going with the first basket of the period for the Nets. Into Smith. Unloads. Can't get it to go. And Brooklyn will now go the other way with it. Here's Mills. Webster covering. And Mills kicks to Garnett. Got a piece of it. Six on the shot clock. That's out of bounds. Brooklyn will retain possession.
A super defensive play. I mean, if that pass gets through, it's probably 2 points.
And he knew that. He knew if it gets through, it's a score. So that's why he sold out for it and got a hand on it. That's some more rugged play from them inside. They have a decent edge in rebounds thus far.
And that hard work on the boards needs to continue. That could be what swings this game eventually.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, Clark, just piling up points in the paint.
Ellis kicks to Plumlee. Knocked away. It's stolen by Curry. Now here's Webster. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. And he hits it and gets hacked on the play. A three-point possibility if he can convert the free throw. Joe
Johnson. Well, I tell you, the Warriors are really a team with gifted passers, especially in the front court. Somewhat surprising that they were only in the middle of the pack in assists last season, and one of the worst teams when it comes to turnovers.
Warriors leading by seven. Down low. Stevenson again. Dallas. That's good. And that's now 11 points for Lance Stevenson. The Nets have gone 2 of 4 shooting the ball here in the second. Quarter number two, around 3 minutes gone by. And Mills kicks to Johnson. Pass to Plumlee. It's tipped. It's taken away by Smith. Moving it up. Outside for Curry. And there's the feed to Smith. Back to Curry. Goes back up. Brooklyn with the rebound.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those two in the first quarter.
Ellis dishes to Johnson. And there's the pass to Mills. He feeds it to Ellis. And stolen by Wright. And here we go.
Oh, my goodness. What a huge play.
Tell you what, he's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Absolutely insane with that dunk.
Well, now they're starting to rub it in. Aren't they up? Build up a lead, and here we go, folks. It's showtime.
And why not? I mean, the more plays they make like that, the more they'll have these guys on the ropes.
Timeout called. The Nets. And as with any timeout at this point of the game, important to go over the strategies that are working and those that are needed in terms of adjustments. And, of course, the opportunity, guys, to get hydrated with Gatorade before coming back onto the floor. We've seen some good action so far, and there's more of it to come.
Yeah, this game has been physical. It's been fast. It's been high-paced. So anytime you're in a situation like this where it's really a hard-fought game, critical to keep yourself hydrated throughout.
And a chance here to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Thank you, Kevin. For Harrison Barnes, it's been a lifelong goal to play in the NBA. Back in high school in Iowa, to raise travel money for tournaments, Barnes, his mother, and his sister would go to Iowa State Cyclones games and collect recyclables. Barnes said, "You learn from those times. They build something in you. I know what it took for me to get here." Kevin, sounds like some character.
And his hard work continues, Doris. Thank you. Jefferson's checked in for the Warriors. Harris comes in for Steph Curry. Johnson can't get it to go. Warriors leading by 11. Here's Harris. In the corner, it's Jefferson. Out to Smith. Six to shoot. The shot is off. Excellent defense there from Boozer. Nets trail by 11. Pass to Harrison. Kicks it to Williams. Plumlee sets the pick for Williams. And it's Johnson again missing. Harris kicks to Smith. And he uses the glass on the lane. Smith's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And now we can see them really working it inside.
Yeah, taking advantage of the defense, really pounding it down low.
Hairston again, Stevenson. And Plumlee kicks to Williams. Inside. Here's Plumlee. And he can't stop this drought. Another miss.
Mason Plumlee was a tad old for an NBA rookie last season. He turned 24 in March. Perhaps affected his draft stock, but it certainly got him to the NBA with an NBA-ready frame. And I like his mobility and quickness as a big man.
Jefferson, that's for two. Plumlee with the rebound. Plumlee's got 5 rebounds tonight. Williams for 3. Warriors with the rebound. Smith's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
And Plumlee's role on the Nets, attacking the rim and converting at over 70% at the basket last season. And an overall field goal percentage of almost 66%. Excellent efficiency.
Well, I tell you what, getting out in transition has really been a big part of this run they're on now.
Well, that's the best way to score in bunches. Just run and drop a bucket in before the team can set up its defense.
Williams again. Harris. The dish now to Stevenson. Plumlee with the rebound. Plumlee's got 6 rebounds now in the game. And Plumlee a pleasant surprise with his shot blocking last season.
Yeah, he doesn't have super long arms, but he's got major bounce ability, and that serves him well as he transitioned from college, where he wasn't a huge shot blocker, to the NBA, where he's shown some prowess in that area.
For Brooklyn, they have been at their free throws in this one, going 3 of 6 so far.
And you look at the numbers from a year ago, guys, this is a club that hit about 75% of its free throws.
And the first one drops.
You know, this Golden State team is clearly on the rise, but they're not without weaknesses. A bad turnover differential and free throw differential, both things that have plagued this team.
Catching up on the changes for Golden State. Brand comes in for Smith. And Steph Curry subbed in for Harris. And the Nets also making a change. Biombo is checked in for Plumlee. Right, the pass to Jefferson. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Brand. Right dishes to Brand. And that one's good.
Things have changed a little bit here in the second quarter, guys, and we're seeing them start to convert a lot of second-chance opportunities.
Yeah, and I'm sure the coach has to be happy about this. I mean, the hustle underneath is paying off in a big way.
Double team on Boozer. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
Ben, you look at the free throw disparity for the Warriors. Not the most surprising stat. They're more of a jump shooting team than a slashing team. But if you're going to settle for jump shots, then you can't also turn it over at a high rate. I think that's where they have to improve.
And Steph Curry, an all-star starter last season, but he also led the league in turnovers, Clark, with over four a game.
Well, the other side of that coin is he did set a career high in assists as well, but there's no question when you talk about him solidifying his place among the elite point guards in the league, the turnover numbers have to come down, and I'm sure he'll work on it.
Now, here's Curry. 16-point lead, the largest margin in the game.
And he may be the guy to put this game even farther out of reach.
Here's Williams. He's got 10. Chauncey kicks to Garnett. To the wing right side. On its way from Dudley for two. That's good, and it's Johnson with the assist. And it's the Warriors' ball. They're on a 17-6 run. Curry passes to Brand. And another basket for Golden State. And Brooklyn has possession. It's an 18-point game. Williams again. It's Curry. Let's it fly from 18. Williams can't get it to go.
And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle on the board.
Well, the main thing is they haven't allowed many second chance opportunities. That is always going to allow you to maintain your lead.
Brand, good.
It took him a little while to get into the flow of this game, but now he's definitely found his stride and rhythm.
Timeout called by Brooklyn.
Well, Steph Curry, of course, deadly from outside the arc. But last season, he tried to improve his ability to get to the rim. In fact, he significantly increased his points in the paint last year.
Anderson comes in for Brandon Wright. And it's Webster in for Lance Stevenson. Then for the Nets, Plumlee comes in for Kevin Garnett. And it's Ellison for Joe Johnson. And for Curry, improving his driving ability. He already had the handle, but he tried to work on his strength to ward off contact.
And Kevin, you know, film study is also playing a role in that progression and development. He not only improved his finishing ability inside, he also got to the line more often, a result of being more confident in his strength. 24 seconds.
Nets trailed by 18. On the wing, Williams. Breaks it off the glass. Williams has got 12.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on him.
Oh, and it looks like that's going to be a goaltending call. Yep, that's it. So they'll get the basket.
He got there late, but you do have to like the aggressiveness to go after the block. But that one's going to count.
.116 left to play here in the second quarter. And he gets the bucket.
Well, offensively, he's taken a solid opening quarter and just built on it here in the second.
And Doris Burke has something for us. Hey, Doris.
Well, Kevin, Steve Kerr taking over as head coach of the Warriors, a five-time NBA champion. His focus is on creating sustained success. He said, we've got a chance to be really good for the next decade. Let's just take a swing every year and be consistent with our efforts, and we'll have our chances. And we get to watch them, Kevin.
Looking to build something that'll last. Thank you, Doris. There's 45 seconds left from the first half of basketball. And Webster kicks to Jefferson. Puts up a three. And the Warriors get it back. Outside Curry. And out of bounds as the Nets gain possession.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. A terrible turnover.
27 seconds left from the first half. Ellis outside. Boozer trying to get open. And the shot is good. And that's now 11 points for Monte Ellis.
I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
I agree. They need more energy in the post, maybe some double teaming. They've got to get their defense in gear.
As we begin the second half, first half wasn't even close, guys, and we'll see if there is a comeback on our hands or more of the same as we get the third quarter started. Really an incredible game from Stephen Curry.
Yeah, the magic touch with the ball. He just made great decisions, piling up the assists there in the first half, and really doing a nice job for his teammates.
You know, it isn't a very common occurrence, Steve. Typically, he's more likely to be on the receiving end of the pass, but so far, it's been the other way around here.
Setting the floor for the Nets. Miller is up there with Garnett. Then there's Plumlee. And it's Mills. And it's Ellis in the two-guard spot. The shot by Curry, no good.
You know, even though he missed that one, great shooters have a way of feeling when they've got enough room to pull the trigger.
Yeah, not enough defensive coverage there to prevent him from firing that time. But I think if he's open, he's got to let that thing fly.
And Ellis throws it down.
He's done a ton to help his team, guys, and he may have to do more if they're going to come back and win.
Stevenson drives in. Plumlee with the steal. Mills dishes to Ellis. Feeds to Miller. He kicks it to Garnett. Five to shoot. Dishes it to Mills. And we're just about a minute and a half into the third quarter of basketball. The drive by Ellis. And it's Miller in the corner. Good, and the assist goes to Ellis. Ellis has
got three assists now in this one.
Their second half has started quite well. They've been good on three of their first four attempts.
Now here's Curry. He's got 17. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Curry's got 19 points.
Virtually uncontested. It's nice to be able to add to the lead without really having to work for it.
Mills passes to Ellis. He dishes it to Mills. Hits the front of the rim and out.
Awesome defense. I mean, he'll hit those unless you're right in his grill. You know, when you have the number of stars and impact players that the Nets do, you can play against anybody. And they were tough against the Western Conference opponents last year.
Nets trail by 17. Pass to Ellis. Shot clock at 6. All sorts of time. That's good. Ellis has got 15 points.
I'll tell you what, he's enjoyed a very good day shooting the ball so far. He can bring them right back into this.
Curry kicks to Smith. And he makes it look easy, dunking it hard with one hand.
Flying high and throwing down the hard one-hander.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys.
And he does it as well as anyone. Tremendous skill in the air.
And it's Ellis penetrating. Plumlee is just DeMills. And the Nets, another three.
Those are starting to add up. Of their last five baskets, three of them have been three-pointers.
And it's not just great offense, Clark. The defense is really lacking. Not enough energy on their closeouts.
Smith sets the pick for Curry. And here we go. Brooklyn fast break. They get it back. Garnett the pass to Ellis. Over Smith. Miller kicks to Mills. On the wing, Ellis. Pass to Mills. And here's Miller outside. Here's Plumlee. And at last, they get one to fall. Plumlee's got his first basket.
Did you see the defense get caught standing around that time, giving up an easy second chance bucket?
Simply need more of an effort on the boards there, Steve. They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from inside the paint area.
The defense has to make an adjustment. They've got to string together some stops or, at the very least, try to force this team into some bad shots.
Here's Mills. Harrison Barnes picking up that last basket. There's Miller with the three. Miller with another miss.
Defense didn't give him any space there.
Curry dishes to Smith. And he caught that pass in full stride on his way to the big slam.
Big time finish. Emphatic.
He hangs on the rim, too, just for good measure.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with a little showboating out there.
Here's Garnett. And that's collected by Smith. Warriors leading by 16. Anderson a screen on Miller. Barnes can't get it to go.
Boy, that's a warm-up jumper there. I mean, when you're a pro, you can't make excuses for missing that one.
Over to the left wing. Out to Miller. The feed to Ellis. Back to Miller. From deep three-point range, Miller with another miss.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Wow, look at that. Yes. That athletic play. Incredible.
Now, Clark, that is just ridiculous.
Absolutely filthy. I don't remember ever seeing a dunk like that in a game. I certainly can't remember the last time I saw it.
Oh, man, that was just amazing.
Timeout called. The Nets
Well, when Harrison Barnes first stepped onto the scene, it was in the middle of the Warriors' 2013 playoff run. But he didn't exactly build upon that streak as people were hoping for last year. The playing time just wasn't there.
Checked in for Harrison Barnes. Brooklyn making some changes. Nets trailed by 18.
And I remember that run for Barnes. He would play as a stretch four and looked unguardable at times in their series against the Nuggets and then the Spurs. Definitely was hoping for more of that this past season.
Anderson, a screen on Johnson. And Chris Anderson picks up the foul. And that'll be his third foul so far. And Brooklyn has possession. Outside Williams. Right side Williams. To the right side. Down to five on the shot clock. Johnson from outside. Can't get it to go. Jefferson with a nice deep. You know, for Barnes, it was an awkward place for him to be in. They brought in Iguodala, and he was moved to the bench. A lot of people thought that that'd be a boon for him, because he would be more focused on the offensive side of things with that second unit in particular and could really thrive.
Yeah, and the change in role and adjusting to being the first option with the second unit, I think was overwhelming for him. And, you know, I think you have to remember Barnes is still a very young player, a lot of room for growth, very talented, very skilled, and he's going to get a lot better.
That drops. 16 points for Williams. Left side Curry. Connects on the 17-footer. And the Warriors lead by 18.
Well, there you go. If you're going to continue to give up open jump shots, you're not going to get back into this game.
It's Williams with the drive. Here's Dudley. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist. Dudley's got five.
Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
Smith sets the pick for Curry. Beyond the arc. And he gets it to go. Curry's got 24.
And it looks to me like he still has some of the shooting touch that he displayed in the first.
Joe Johnson on the way. No good.
He's giving them little to nothing at the offensive end. I can't put it any other way.
Smith with a screen on Williams. Curry kicks to Smith. Stevenson outside. Front pass the arc.
I like the defense, guys. Really getting a hand up and challenging shots.
Yeah, Steve, lurking on that shot, and that was a tough one.
Even though the Nets staged a great comeback last season, you have to wonder if they'll view what they did as a disappointment.
Well, they did bring in some big-name stars, but still ended up, I think, right in the middle of the playoff pack in the East and perhaps fell a little short of what they hoped to accomplish last season.
Anderson, a screen on Johnson. Stevenson passes to Anderson. Stolen by Boozer. Johnson outside. .156 left in the third. Trying to find Boozer, and he does now. The shot by Williams, no good.
major defensive lapse right there. I mean, he's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You've got to stay attached to him. You're lucky he couldn't punish them for it.
It's deflected. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
The outside leaner. Good on the jump shot. Williams has got four this quarter.
You know, it went down, guys, but still unusual to go to the leaner there with so much space around them.
Smith sets the pick for Curry. Into Smith. Brooklyn with the rebound. Johnson's got four rebounds in this game. Williams dishes to Boozer. That's out of bounds. Brooklyn will retain possession. Some changes for Golden State. White, he's checked in for Anderson. And it's early in for Richard Jefferson. 56 seconds left to play here in the third. Williams attacking. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Joe Johnson is also sometimes called ISO Joe because of his ability to produce buckets going one-on-one. There's nobody better in that situation in terms of creating the shot with ease and never shying away from the big moment.
And you talk about Johnson's ability to get his shot off. 6'7", huge frame for a two-guard. And with his ball handling ability, he can really create space for himself.
Eldon Brands checked in for Josh Smith. Kevin Garnett, he's checked in for the Nets. Curry, wide open. And the three ball is good. Curry's got two now from beyond the arc in the third for the Warriors. And Johnson's so smooth, Clark, but you know, Joe, his size and strength, sometimes it seems like he could do more to press the issue to try to foul.
Well, you know, I'm not going to be overly critical. This guy is terrific as a one-on-one isolation player. Used to average over 5 free throws a game, but that number has declined. But that may be more a function of him maturing in his career and picking his spots to be aggressive and not wanting to draw contact.
Here's Brand. The shot misses.
This is why you need size inside, the ability to contest shots and force misses.
Steve, that's exactly.
And here at the end of the. The third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Warriors lead by 12. We're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of the fourth quarter next. Here's Harris. Harris is out there with Webster. Then it's all points.
Well, the defense has to battle him down there and keep him out of position in the first place. Do your work early.
Knocks it loose. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Nets will retain possession. Here's Mills. Shot clock at 6. To the left side wing. All alone. Count it, and the Warrior lead has been cut down to just 12 points on the bucket from Hairston.
Looks like he was trying to go for a degree of difficulty points on that shot.
Brand inside. Guarded by Garnett. No good from Brand. Nets trail by 12. Johnson kicks to Hairston. It's stolen by Early. Webster, that's for 2. Almost, but it rolls out.
Ill-advised shot selection right there, Clark.
Really was. I mean, very low percentage shot there.
Now the pass to Garnett. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Martell Webster. That's his first foul. about a minute and a half into the fourth quarter now. Here's Mills. Know what? Great D that time from Brand.
And they forced the miss with that good defensive rotation. They're playing well together as a unit.
They get the rebound. Right. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play chance here. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Warriors.
Well, they're taking high-percentage shots in the paint. I like the way their offense is clicking.
Well, it's been a super performance from beyond the arc, too. I mean, they've been reining in those threes. With the success they've been having from the three-point line since halftime, I'll bet you that scoreboard starts to look a lot different real soon.
Of course, they have to stay hot, but if they do, I think you're right, Clark, particularly if they can convert defense into offense.
And it's Johnson penetrating. Garnett left side. Shot clock at five. The lead now cut to single digits. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back. Now a timeout called by Golden State.
Kevin Garnett was the fifth pick back in 1995. He's had a long, illustrious Hall of Fame career. He was the league MVP back in 2004.
Checked in for Brand. Harrison Barnes comes in for Early. Lance Stevenson's checked in for Martell Webster. And Curry subbed in for Harris. And then for Brooklyn, Boozer, he's checked in for Garnett. Dudley comes in for Joe Johnson. And Darren Williams is subbed in for Patty Mills. And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Kevin, during that last break, I heard the Warriors coach as he addressed his team. He wanted his guys to keep up the intensity, saying, if any of you think this game is over, you're wrong. We've got work to do. I don't want to see any letdown on the defensive end of the floor. Guys, let's watch how it plays out.
The kick out to Williams. Out to the right wing. Here's Hairston. No good on the triple. Warriors leading by eight. 4-on-3 break. Stolen by Doug. Hairston, the pass to Boozer. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
How about the passing there? Moving the ball without any thought, without any agenda.
It's hard to overstate all the points they've scored on assists today. Beautiful to watch.
Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. That's good. And that's now 29 points for Steph Curry.
And he came off that screen. The defense just couldn't get over the top. Beautiful play.
Yep, and without a hand in his face, he's going to bury those.
Here's Williams. It's rebounded by Golden State. Their biggest lead of the game was 21.
Another strong rebound, just like we've gotten used to seeing from them today.
Yeah, one or two more of those, and this lead will be double digits.
Barnes dishes brief to right, and there's the three-second violation. Kevin Garnett is checked in for Mason Plumlee. Nets trailed by eight. Outside Williams. Double team on Williams. Right wing. And here's Dudley for three. Tries again. No luck. And Golden State will come the other way.
deflects the pass. Hairston with the steal. In low to Garnett. And that one is stuffed right through.
Well, when they desperately needed to get things turned around, they were able to do it and claw their way back in.
And they fed off their defense just as much as their offense in putting this run together.
And Wright kicks to Stevenson. Pocket six. Curry passes to Stevenson. It's tipped. And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. And the Warriors making a change here. Anderson's checked in. Nets trailed by six. Boozer a screen on Curry. Hairston kicks to Williams. And that's out of bounds. Brooklyn will retain possession.
14 seconds on the shot clock.
Dudley, the pass to Hairston. Six to shoot. Passes it to Dudley.
This has not at all been the kind of performance they've needed out of him.
Curry with some nice D.
Just an enormous advantage for them on the boards.
Guys, the key to the lead, to me, has been they've dominated the glass. It's that simple.
Here's Smith. And the layup's good off the glass. And the Warriors lead by eight.
Yeah, no mistakes on the offensive execution there.
Brooklyn's gotten off four three-pointers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen. Here's Hairston. Drains the three-pointer.
Excellent ball movement there, guys.
Yeah, I think that's what's keyed this run, Clark, because they're keeping the ball moving. Defense hasn't been able to set up.
Here's Curry with the three.
He's been the guy on the boards today, no question.
Steve, you're all over it. I mean, his numbers back it up. He's been working extremely hard out there.
And Williams, here we go. Outside Williams. It's rebounded by Stevenson. Stevenson's got his third rebound on the night. It's three outside. That's good, and it's Stevenson with the assist. Stevenson's got his seventh assist in the game.
He has really punished these defenders today. No matter who's been on him, he's been giving them medicine.
Williams kicks to Hairston. He feeds it to Garnett. The rebound by Anderson. Warriors leading by eight. All going up court. Stevenson with it. Williams picks him up. And the basket by Curry.
He's having quite the quarter here, guys. I mean, shooting the ball extremely well.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn.
It's early, but you can already make a case for Curry as one of the best shooters of all time. Really, it's a combination of his ability to hit shots, but also his ability to create his own shot. Very rare to have both those abilities.
For Brooklyn. Plumlee is checked in for Garnett. Johnson comes in for Jared Dudley. And it's Ellison for Hairston. And if you do consider Curry to be the greatest shooter already, you're in good company. Last season, Kevin Durant Clark gave his opinion that Curry is already the best.
Yeah, you know, this is going to be debated by people for a long time, and I don't know where the answer is going to land. But Curry definitely is in the equation already with his resume and record-breaking three-point shooting.
Count it, and the Warrior lead has been cut down to just 8 points on the bucket from Ellis. Smith sets the pick for Curry. Got a piece of it. Plumlee with the steal. Ahead,
And there's Joe Johnson on the assist by Williams. Williams has got four assists in the game.
Well, they've got a big edge now when you look at the fast break points, guys.
It hasn't helped put them in front, Steve, but they need to keep playing that rapid-fire basketball. That's their style.
Plumlee sets the pick for Williams. Johnson with it. Now guarded by Stevenson. And it's sent back by Anderson. And they're able to recover.
And I think the lead they've built here, guys, is in large part due to what they've done on the boards.
Absolutely. I mean, they have a plus 10 advantage in rebounds, and they've been in total control of the backcourt.
Well, you knew he'd win that race.
Definitely. I mean, that's what you call early offense.
Stevenson drives in. Got it. Good job in the low post. And here is Williams. That was with a screen on Stevenson. Puts one up from 19. Misses off the left iron. And a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
I tell you, he's really carrying a lot of the load offensively, and that's almost always good news for them.
Mets trail by 8. Williams in the post. He's guarded by Stevenson. Williams gets the bucket.
You can see that they're not as aggressive from the three-point arc. They had far more attempts in the first half.
Curry attacking Anderson. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Brooklyn's gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc since the final quarter's gotten underway. In the corner, it's Boozer. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2.
Obvious foul.
Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned those free throws.
Right on the first, and that narrows the gap to 7. Second free throw, no good. A tough break there.
He needed to cash in on all those. Missed opportunities at the line are the last thing they need right now.
.130 left in the fourth quarter. Clock at 6. Into Smith. Williams dishes to Ellis. Kicks to Plumlee. Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession. Warriors leading by 7. Curry attacking. Kicks it out to Stevenson. Off the mark there with a 3-point shot.
He's not exactly striping them from deep. He had 1 3 ball in the first half. Still bagels in the second.
These are incredible rebounding numbers. I'm not sure if we've ever seen anything like this, Clark.
That's for sure, Steve. I mean, a superhuman performance on the backboard. Well done.
And again, no good by Golden State.
Boy, that's a surprising miss right there. He usually feasts on those wide-open opportunities.
Johnson with it. Now the dish to Boozer. Back to Johnson. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Ellis can't get it to go.
That's excellent defense right there on the perimeter.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Stevenson again. It's Williams. And the basket by Stevenson.
This game's over, guys. I think we can say that with certainty.
Yeah, I agree with you there. We have officially reached garbage time.